architecture should be such that when you see somebody walking in, or when you yourself walk into that space, that first word that comes to your mind is, wow, what happened here and how did this happen? I think if you achieve that, you really achieved it. We started our career with a developer, and because of that one developer, which was a commercial development for a township, we just kept getting these developer-led projects one after the other. And you've done so much residential, which is market driven. There are, you know, apartment sizes given to you, there's a certain number given to you, and everything is more maths than anything else, and it's all about sellability and what will sell in this market or in that market. So one actually thinks that what else can one do in a residential building? And here there was this opportunity where the person who wanted to make this building was actually doing the building for the first time. He took me to the plot and said, you know, tell me, what should I make here? So I said, you should make a nice residential building. And you should make a residential building which is suited for Ranchi. So you can't pick a Bombay building or a Delhi building or a Hyderabad building and put it in Ranchi and expect it to sell. So I'll tell you why. Because in Ranchi, everybody is used to living in bungalows. Now, Bombay and Delhi can expand, but Ranchi is locked by Adivasi land on all sides. So actually, Ranchi cannot expand. And population increase, like in every other city, is happening in Ranchi as well. So what has happened in Ranchi is, over the last 2 decades, a plot has gone up 25 times, 30 times in value. Because there's just that much scarcity of land. So, and all these residential apartments have come up for this reason. But after residential apartments being there, they still remain unoccupied. 5 years after getting made, 7 years after getting made. And I used to see this, and I used to ask these questions as to why are these buildings empty still. I told him, what you need to do here is, you need to give a bungalow in the sky, literally. So it's not just about creating a penthouse on a building. The entire building should be like that. So he said, what do you mean by that? So I said, firstly, you should design only one apartment to floor. And we had a very small plot, so in any case, you couldn't design something very lavish. So what we managed to fit in is a 3-bedroom, decent-sized apartment, 2,000 square feet. And then each room of each of these apartments opens out into a balcony space, which is 2 floors high. And your neighbor on top of you cannot look down into your balconies, and he has his own, or she has his own, her own balconies, which are again 2 floors high. So it's not about every apartment opening into a balcony, it's about every room of every apartment, including the kitchens. Kitchen, dining, all 3 bedrooms and living room open into 24 feet high spaces, and which are extensions of your indoor space. The whole idea was trying to recreate a bungalow in the sky. And one of those most important things is, when you are in a bungalow, you enter the gate, it's yours. You enter the door, it's yours. You don't share a lobby with somebody. So that's why the whole basic premise of this flat is that when a person walks in from this entrance lobby, that's the entrance lobby. And you have a bedroom here. This whole thing is the living dining. So this is the basic plan. Person walks in, this entire space is the living room. And if you look inside, there is literally zero passage space. So you have a bedroom here, a bedroom here, a bedroom here. So all 3 corners are bedrooms, 1 corner is a kitchen. This living room opens up into alternate balconies on each floor, and each of these balconies is angular. And then each one of these rooms opens into also an angular balcony, including the kitchen. Ordinarily, what will happen, let's say in cross section, these are 2 different floors. If you make a balcony in a Bombay or a Delhi building, this is a person standing here, the person standing above. Every balcony is identical. So a balcony is completely sheltered, and it always feels semi-enclosed, as opposed to the room behind it, which feels fully enclosed, as opposed to the space outside, which is fully open. So it's enclosed, semi-open, and fully open. Now we want to create that open space of a terrace within a balcony. How do you do that? You have a small plot. One way to do it is you step the entire building back like this. But if we were to step a building like this back, this building would have gone out of its plot. So there was no way of giving a terrace in the conventional way. So we came up with this idea that we'll twist these balcony spaces now, an enlarged portion of this balcony in plan, that is the floor. And this is the roof of this balcony. So which means that a portion of this is sheltered like a conventional balcony and a portion of it is open to sky, like a terrace. So you are now giving that choice to any individual who's walking out of their room to stand outside here in this sheltered space or to stand outside here in this open to sky space. So 1/3 of this balcony is like an open to sky terrace and 2/3 of it is sheltered. So this choice is given to every single person in every single room of every single apartment in this. And this is what makes it different and makes it unique. Now, what this does in terms of the elevation of the building is that it gives us its unique characteristic like this. So the building also gets this whole organic kind of feel, a very sculpted kind of look. And at the same time, what you're doing is you're giving these open spaces to every single room. So that's what makes this building unique. So while we've done a reasonably large number of residential projects of all kinds in different cities, we find that developers in India are not open to doing something unique, to doing something different. So starting from the brief where we actually created the brief for the plot to the final outcome. And in doing so, we did it in a unique way, which allowed people to perceive those spaces in a different way. So a number of factors that make this very interesting. One is that you got your way with the brief. The second is that you got your way with trying to create something that is so open, because that's what a house should feel like. It should feel open. You should not feel that you're closed into a box, which is what 99% of the buildings do. So the client in that sense gave us his free hand, and we were able to achieve something that is completely unique and completely different to experience. I mean, and the most sincere appreciation came from the people who moved into this apartment, saying that they have never experienced an apartment like this. I mean, this building won the leading European Architects Forum award for the best residential building of the year worldwide in London, beating several buildings from across the world in different places. And this is a project in Ranchi which is done in 1800 rupees a square foot. In fact, the only constraint we had on this project was the client said, well, please don't make me spend more than this X amount, and it was done within that much. Because if one was to spend more than that, the project would not have been feasible in a small city like Ranchi. So we've actually used a contractor from the city, and again, a huge credit to that contractor as well. And it took 4 years to come up because it was a slow process, but the end result is that it came out exactly the way it was supposed to come and actually went beyond what we thought would happen.